Miley Cyrus and Caitlyn Carter get raunchy in club together.
Billie Eilish opens up about her love life.
Ooh, and Millie Bobby Brown is exploring a new career path.
Yeah, all that and more on today's Daily Hollywood Rundown.
What is up, you guys? Welcome to today's episode of the Daily Hollywood Rundown. I'm so excited, I can't get my words out because Drew is here today.
Hi, you guys.
And it's just Drew and I, like the two girls.
Just us, man.
Just us, man. This is very exciting. A very exciting episode of DHR.
Estrogen.
I nearly kicked that over. I'm Susan Morad, of course, if it's your first time here.
I'm Drew Dorsey.
And we're very excited.
So excited. You're giving me the energy I need.
Oh, good.
I haven't eaten, you guys, and I'm about to turn into a monster.
Well, just contain the monster, Drew, just for a little while. If it's your first time here, if it's not your first time here, but you're not a subscriber, I don't know what you're waiting for. Hit that subscribe button right there and hit the bell, and that way you'll know as soon as we post some great, clever news updates. Mm-hmm. And we read your comments, so leave us comments, I was about to say, because we have this segment, Drew, I don't know if you've seen it, that we do, You're So Clever, where we read out some of the funny, random comments of the week.
Oh.
And we've been having a lot of fun with it, and you guys have been having a lot of fun with your comments as well. So leave us comments, and maybe you'll get featured in You're So Clever or Fan of the Week.
Oh my God, so fun. I want to be featured.
Oh my God, yes.
Is that selfish because I work here? Is that too much?
No, I don't think so.
I'll leave it for you guys.
I don't
guys.
Think so. But we've got so much news to get through, Drew.
So much. We need to talk about Khloe Kardashian.
Oh, yes.
Another day, another social media post that's getting the Kardashians dragged over something. Am I right? And today, it's a pack of mom shamers who are out to feast on Khloe Kardashian. But first off, can I just say how cute Vacation True and Vacation Shy are with their hands knuckle deep in a bag of Cheetos and veggie straws? They are a whole mood. I want to be them. So the photo in question, Khloe clearly had no idea what she was getting herself into when she posted an adorable set of photos of True Thompson and her cousin Chicago West living their best 12-month-old lives on vacation in the Bahamas. Alongside the photo, she tweeted, quote, "Shy, I heard my mama say vacation calories don't count. True, don't tell me twice, Shy." Okay, not gonna lie, I giggled and I moved on. But Twitter, on the other hand, were out for blood. One Twitter user wrote, "Hey, not trying to be a and I completely understand this is a joke, but even things said in passing can have massive effects on young minds. Be careful what you're teaching. Counting calories is rarely a healthy thing, if ever." Another user got straight to the point, writing, "That's f***ed up." On the contrary, many took this comment as nothing more than just a lesson on healthy eating habits. Meanwhile, a select few also clearly decided to dive real deep into the photo and slam Khloe for letting her kid drink from a plastic straw. One activist wrote, "Hard to be mad about plastic straws when these babies are literal perfection, but seriously, let's teach the next generation about sustainability so they have a planet to live on. Okay, thanks. Bye." Okay, this is the thing. I get it. Body positivity, health, straws are bad for the environment, but y'all, come on. It's like, it's just a photo. She was being funny with
having
the kids.
Having fun, right?
Everyone needs to relax.
Yeah, I think everyone needs to relax. And I just thought it was hilarious when I saw the caption.
Yeah.
And the cutest photos, my God, they're so cute.
They are so cute. I want to eat them.
And there's actually this Instagram account that I just thought of when you were talking about it called Nori's Black Book. And it's actually like one of those sort of parody accounts where it's written as though it's like Northwest's photos and comments. And Khloe follows that account as well. As like I follow it, so I see when she's like photos. And so the captions are really funny, and they're always written as if it's the kids saying certain things. So maybe she got inspired by that and thought she was having, you know, a little bit of fun. And here she is getting dragged again.
Yeah, you win some, you lose some.
All right, Drew, so I'm sure you've been seeing all the reports about Caitlyn Carter and Miley Cyrus's thing that they've got going on. Mm-hmm. And based on reports today by Page Six, apparently things are really heating up for these two. So you may have heard of a place called Soho House. So it's an exclusive elite members club where people go to network, work, or have a nice fancy dinner or a drink, you know, that sort of thing. It's where a lot of celebrities go to kick back, particularly because they have a no photos policy. So their privacy is respected and they can do as they want without getting too much attention. Well, according to Page Six, a source inside the West Hollywood club reported that they saw Miley and her new bae, Caitlyn Carter, making out and getting pretty hot and heavy all over the place on Friday night. Literally hours after Miley dropped her very shady Liam referencing single, Slide Away. The source revealed, quote, "They were obsessed with each other. They couldn't keep their hands off each other. They were kissing and making out everywhere, in the bathroom, at the bar, in the middle of the floor. They were basically having sex." There's no question they're together. Right, okay, that's a pretty graphic description, but okay. And if that didn't sound wild enough, Miley and Caitlyn were allegedly making their PDA parade very noticeable. The source added they were making out all over the place and they didn't care who saw. So as we mentioned, there's a no photo policy, so there's no photo evidence of this. And while this could very well be true, a lot of fans on Twitter are not convinced just yet without the photo evidence, tweeting at Page Six things like, "Pics and video please," as well as "pics or it didn't happen. I said pics, damn it," while others called it gross or fake news. I don't think it's fake news. I mean, I don't know. I know that there's no photos because Soho House has a no photo policy. Yeah. You might remember actually last week those photos, or the week before, of Gigi Hadid with Tyler Cameron.
Yeah.
That was like someone took a sneaky photo at a different Soho House. So yeah, they might have lost their membership now.
No.
But really quickly, with Caitlyn and Miley. So yesterday I got a text from a friend,
yeah,
who was in Studio City at Alfred saying, "Caitlyn and Miley are here." And I flipped out.
Inside scoop.
Right, inside scoop. I was like, get a photo, get a video, get something. But it was like a friend's friend that was there.
Yeah.
And then they didn't get it because it was like a guy and he was just like, oh.
Like whatever.
I'm not interested kind of thing. But
interesting.
But yeah, I don't know. What do you think about the Page Six reports?
Well, first of all, I think that Miley can live her life. She can do whatever she wants. Clearly she's hurting. She went through a breakup recently, like a divorce actually.
Yeah.
Little her over life. Whoever, did someone take photos? How
no.
do we know?
We don't know. We don't know.
It's hearsay.
So yeah, let's wait to see some more. I'm sure we will.
Something. Mm-hmm. Something's gonna come out. Mm-hmm. Okay, Susan.
Mm-hmm.
Moving on to less scandalous things.
Oh, okay.
Millie Bobby Brown is venturing into a new career path. Do you have any idea what Kim Kardashian, Kylie Jenner, Rihanna, and now Millie Bobby Brown all have in common?
What?
Millie is joining this squad of celebs who have founded beauty empires. The list of celebrity-founded beauty brands expands almost every day, and Millie Bobby Brown is jumping on board with her own Gen Z-focused beauty brand called Florence by Mills.
Every young person deserves to have a good start with their skin.
She announced the news on her Instagram page saying, quote, "So here it is, Florence by Mills. Literally the love of my life. I can't begin to explain the love I have for this and how hard but crazy excited I was to create it. 2 years of creating a beauty and skincare brand, geez, that's a long time to keep a secret, but now I can finally share the news with you all." Millie might only be 15 years old, but apparently she's been working on the skincare line since she was 13. Millie apparently came up with this idea after sitting in makeup chairs for years as an actor, which makes total sense. Her face began to negatively react to some of the products used, so she spent the past 2 years developing the clean skincare line that is gentle enough for young skin. Millie named the brand Florence by Mills after her great-grandmother Florence, which is really sweet, and on top of keeping the brand vegan and cruelty-free, she is also keeping it at an affordable price range, from $10 to $34, and will be sold online as well as in Ulta and Boots. And fans just like us are extremely excited about this launch. One person wrote, quote, "Vegan and cruelty-free? Girl, I love you." And another said, "We are so proud of you, Millie. You keep inspiring us and show that there's no age minimum for doing something great. I hope you'll get tons of support for this. It's what you deserve. I love you."
Oh,
Millie Bobby Brown. Hey,
Millie Bobby Brown, killing it.
Wow, I feel
killing
like
it.
Everyone and their mama has a beauty line.
Right? I feel like Millie is catered to like a different audience to what, like Fenty, you know, Selena Gomez. There's talk about her starting a line.
Lady Gaga,
mm-hmm. Of course, Kylie Skin, Kim Kardashian.
Yeah.
So there's a lot out there, but I feel like she's probably bringing something fresh.
It's like a
and
new.
Yeah.
Younger generation.
Yeah, get it, girl.
I like the abbreviation of Mills.
Mills.
Very hip and trendy.
All right, so Billie Eilish is having a massive week, you guys. She just hit number one on the Billboard 100, knocking off Lil Nas X after 19 weeks at number one, which is amazing.
Jeez.
She's also on the cover of V Magazine's 20th anniversary issue, looking bomb. And she also opened up to another outlet about her love life. As we just mentioned, Billie Eilish yesterday dethroned Lil Nas X's Old Town Road from the number one spot on the Billboard Hot 100 chart after 19 long weeks. But that's not the only goal she kicked this week, you guys. Billie is also the first artist born this century to go number one. And at 17, she's also the youngest person since Lorde who topped the charts in 2013 with Royals. Billie is clearly a force, but you guys already know that. Yesterday, V Magazine also debuted Billie as their 20th anniversary issue cover star, where she's giving us cool, super edgy bridal vibes on the cover, along with a series of other epic Billie-esque shots. In the accompanying interview, which was done by Pharrell Williams, Billie talked about her rise in the industry as well as her fashion choices. Now, you guys might remember the interview she did with Vogue Australia, where it was reported she wears baggy clothing to keep people from judging her body. Well, Billie wanted to elaborate on her earlier comments when Pharrell asked her what was one of the biggest misconceptions about her. Billie said, quote, "The positive comments about how I dress have this shaming element. Like, I'm so glad that you are dressing like a boy so that other girls can dress like boys so that they aren't. That's basically what it sounds like to me, and I can't overstate how strongly I do not appreciate that at all. I have never in my life felt that way. I don't like that there's this weird new world of supporting me by shaming people that may not want to dress like me." And one more golden Billie nugget for you guys today. Billie actually recently opened up about her love life to 3 Vore 12 Extra and revealed who she's in love with. When asked by the interviewer, "I heard you were in love," this is what Billie had to say.
"I was in love.
But not at the moment.
Not at the moment. I'm in love with myself. I was in love. I am not no more.
Okay.
I'm in love with her.
Me.
Yes."
Oh, I love Billie Eilish.
Falling in love is a terrible idea. Don't do it. Stay away.
It's a trap. It's a trap.
It's a trap.
It's a trap. But she's absolutely killing it right now. And I just cannot wait to see what's next for Billie. Like, at such a young age, she's doing so incredibly well.
So much
and
stuff.
Yes, just bring it on. All right, Drew, everybody watching, do you know what time it is?
I'm very excited. It's my favorite part.
It's time for the final rundown.
That was fun. I like the drum roll part. I'm very excited because happy birthday, Demi Lovato.
Oh, hey, wait, Drew, I gotta kick off the clock. You guys are gonna keep that in. Are you ready, Drew? I know you're
ready
hungry,
again.
Drew.
I know, okay. I'm ready
All right,
again.
1.5 minutes on the clock, and
too excited. Did we start it?
Yeah. Happy birthday, Demi Lovato.
Wow. Demi turns 27 years old today, and hashtag happy birthday Demi was trending on Twitter with fans and friends wishing the star a happy birthday. Ariana Grande also celebrated and wished Demi an early happy birthday. And then Demi also shared these really sweet clips of Ari celebrating her and her prayer that she does before her show. And she also shared a clip with Scooter and Ari, and they were wishing her happy birthday, and Scooter forgot to record, but they got it at the end and it worked out. It's adorable.
It's adorable. It's adorable. Speaking of adorable, PewDiePie got married and posted about it and shared the news on Instagram. He shared some photos of the wedding day to his Instagram along with the caption, "We are married. I am the happiest I can be. I'm so lucky to share my life with this amazing woman." The couple got married on Monday in London's Kew Gardens, and his gorgeous new bride also shared some intimate photos of her own.
All these YouTube weddings, man.
I know.
Love is in the air.
Love is in the air.
And Sam Smith just got candid on Instagram about his mental health and shared what has helped him make it through a tough year. He shared this photo that says, "I am enough," and wrote a long caption that said, quote, "Looking back on a year and a half of therapy and what has been probably the most challenging time of my short 27 years here, Sam learned it's okay not to be able to make sense of everything and turned to Breen Brown and her words, "I am enough," for guidance. Sam hopes his words can comfort his fans. Love that.
Yeah, I love that too.
Enough.
I love it when they get candid about like their own, oh, there you go.
Man.
Man.
I hate when that happens.
Go so fast, but we got through all the news.
We did. We got through it.
We got through it. All right. That is it for today's episode. Oh, I don't want it to end.
It went by so fast.
It went by so fast. Time flies when you're having fun.
It really does. And when you're hungry.
When you're hungry.
But you guys, I have questions.
Yes.
I want to know, what do you guys think of Millie Bobby Brown's new career venture, her beauty line? Will you buy it? Do all the things.
Do all the things. Also, speaking of doing things, even though it has nothing to do with things other than making comments about Khloe Kardashian, what did you think? Did you think people were just like needing to calm down about these particular photos? Did you think people just need to cool it, or you think she really is maybe like, I don't even want to.
Words. English?
Words.
What?
English.
What?
Words. Yeah. Do the thing. Thanks, guys. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye. Hold on, guys, before you go anywhere, catch up on yesterday's episode of DHR. It's right here, and it was a really juicy one, Drew.
Such a juicy one, but also, you guys, you should hit that juicy subscribe button so you get all the, you won't get notifications, but you hit the bell. You